Hi everyone. So I've been tinkering around with PCVR on Quest 2 for about a year and a half now, and as have a lot of us recently, and I've noticed one thing. Why is it so fucking janky? This is something that's probably frustrated a lot of you watching, so I did some digging and found out that ALVR, a wireless VR program that I've used in the past, actually supports using the link cable, albeit with some setup, but it works, and it works well. The only problem is, well, the official guide on the wiki sucks. Sucks really bad. So I wanted to make a better guide for anyone to follow along with. So first off, you'll need a couple things to get this working. You'll need, obviously, a PC capable of PCVR, a link cable, and a headset, such as the Quest lineup or the Pico headsets, and it's important that either of them are in either developer mode or in USB debug mode. Additionally, you'll also need ALVR, a program called ADBForwarder, which I'll explain more in depth later, and SteamVR. All the products and programs I'm using in this video will also be linked in the description to make it easier to find. Steam. Now, to start things off, if you don't already have Steam, you'll need to go to Steam's website, and up near the top of the page, you'll see a green Install Steam button. Once you press this, it'll bring you to their installer page, and you just need to click the blue button to download the installer. Once it's done downloading, just run the installer, and it'll install Steam onto your computer. Then you'll have to log into your account and download SteamVR, which you can do just by searching for it in the store and hitting Add to Library and Download. When it's finished downloading, quickly boot it up once and close it, just so you've opened it at least one time. This is important for setup later. ALVR. In order to install ALVR, first we'll need to go to the GitHub repo and scroll till we find text that reads Windows Installer, and then click on it. Once that's downloaded, you have to right-click the zip file and press Extract All. And when that's done, you'll want to go into the folder named ALVR_Launcher_Windows, and then open the .exe file named ALVR Launcher. It'll prompt you to install the latest update, and you just have to press Add Version and Install, and then it'll install everything for you. After it's done installing, open ALVR by pressing Launch in the launcher, and it'll open up the dashboard, where it'll take you through the first time setup. Just follow the steps it gives you. Last, put your headset on and open the store and search up ALVR. It should be the first result and it should be free. Just open that and press install on the store. ADBForwarder. For ADBForwarder, it's an extremely similar process. We'll just have to go to the GitHub page for it and press the link that says download here. Then press the download named ADBForwarder-Windows-x64.zip. When that's finished downloading, right-click the zip file and press Extract All again, and open the folder once it's finished. Inside the ADBForwarder folder, look for the ADBForwarder.exe file and open that up, and it'll install ADB on your computer if you haven't done that already. When that's done, that's all you need to do with the ADBForwarder. Developer mode or USB debug. For enabling developer mode on the Quest, first you'll need to log into your Meta account on the Meta Developer website and verify your account through some form of 2FA. I would highly recommend just using an authenticator app because typing in your credit card details just doesn't feel right, and it'll make your account more secure anyway in the long run if you're using an authenticator. Once you've verified yourself, you can type in an organization name, which can be anything as long as it's unique. Afterwards, all you have to do is turn on your headset and leave it aside somewhere, and then open the Horizon app on your phone and click on your Quest. Then go into the headset settings, developer mode, and turn developer mode on. As for USB debugging on the Pico, it's a lot more simple. Navigate to the settings and select General, then press the software version around 7 or 8 times. Once you've done that, the developer mode section should appear in the left-hand side of the settings menu. Select developer and enable USB debugging if it isn't already enabled by default. Here comes the most painful part, setting up all the individual pieces. First, let's focus on setting up ALVR. Make sure your PC and a headset are connected to the same Wi-Fi network, or preferably, your computer is connected through Ethernet and your headset is connected on wireless. Then inside of ALVR, on your computer, open the settings and go to the Connections tab. There you'll find an option called Stream Protocol, and you'll want to swap that from UCP to TCP. After you've done that, press the Launch SteamVR button inside of ALVR, and then grab your headset. In the headset, you'll want to open up the ALVR app, and it'll show a hostname and your local IP. On your computer, it should auto-detect and attempt to connect to your headset. add it as a trusted device if it does, and change the IP to 127.0.0.1. If it does not automatically detect your headset, then press the Add Device Manually button and type whatever it is inside your headset as the host name and the IP as 127.0.0.1. Select Save, and that's all the setup inside of ALVR. Now let's set up ADBForwarder. Connect your Quest or Pico to your computer using the link cable and open ADBForwarder on your computer. It should tell you that you need to accept the ADB prompt inside of your headset. So inside of your headset, when that prompt comes up, press Yes or Always Allow from this device. If it doesn't show up, try unplugging and plugging the cable back in while wearing the headset and you should see the prompt. Once you've allowed your computer to use ADB in your headset, ADBForwarder should say that ADB has been enabled and you should replug your headset. Replug the cable one more time and then it should successfully connect to your device. Now we can finally put everything together. Open the ALVR app and ADBForwarder on your computer, then open ALVR in your headset and connect it to your computer with the link cable. Once ADBForwarder reports a successful connection, press the Launch SteamVR button on the PC ALVR app. And with any luck, you should be in the Steam home once you throw on your headset. After that, I encourage you to tinker around with the settings, bitrate, etc. to find out what works best for you. I personally like to use 200 megabytes per second bitrate, 90 Hz refresh rate, and the H.264 encoder, but what works for me may not work the best for you. For anyone wondering, here's what that looks like as well. Now that we've finished setting this up, I hope you can enjoy your PCVR experience, because I know I was a lot happier with my headset and with my computer once I finally managed to find a wired setup that works smoothly, and I can tinker around with it as much as I want, and I'm not restricted by any of Oculus's restrictions, or the restrictions of having to go through Steam Link Wireless. But anyway, I hope all of you have a wonderful day, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye.